I will be nonstop uploading every 2 days. I'll try to upload every day. You guys just have to show me that love and support, that you guys actually like my videos and interact with me. All right. You guys see by the name, shout out to Just Ethan. I'm trying to hit this 1K so we can get monetized and I can start making money off this. Anyways, get straight into the build. All right, for the pie chart, you want to pick the playmaking and shooting, but don't pick the all playmaking pie chart, because that will make you make a slashing playmaker, and you'll get 15 shooting badges and 28 slashing. So you want to 28 playmaking. You want to pick the green and orange pie chart. And for this, you want to, well, I decided to pick the one with the most speed because I want a fast build that can catch up with other players and play good defense. Because the slower your build is, the slower it is at playing defense. So I suggest you guys go with the pie chart with the most speed. And so that is what I picked here. So let's get straight into these attributes. So what you want to do is just max out your shooting and your playmaking gear. Well, no, not max out your playmaking. Just want to max out your shooting and, like, do a lot on your playmaking. As you can see, I maxed out. You need to max out your ball handling and pass accuracy. And then this is when the good part comes in. Upgrade lateral, max out lateral quickness, perimeter defense, steal. And then I upgraded post moves, but then I took it right back off because you don't need 23 playmaking badges. I'm trying to get a lot of defensive badges on this build, so I specifically took stuff off just so the defensive badges could go higher. Because most play shots, it's a basic and has like 6 defensive badges. And to me, that's just not enough. So as you can see, I was taking stuff off just little by little. And then eventually I got my 11 defense. But then I realized I want more than 17 playmaking. I want like around 20. So, you see me taking off stuff from the post fade to put on my defense and on my playmaking. Actually, yeah. And then I just continued. The body shape, you guys, it's all up to you. It's an opinion-based thing. I picked defined because I just want my player with abs. Because, I don't know. People say that it matters, but I don't think it matters, in my opinion. I'm going with 6'5". Because if I go 6'6", I'll lose too much ball handling. But 6'5 is a good height. Because, in my opinion, I think the bigger you are, the better defense you play in the paint. And that's true, because if I'm taller, you can see my defensive attributes going up. If I go 6'6", I lose too much ball handling, and I can't get that back. And you can see my speed and vertical and stuff is going down if I go 6'6". So that's here why I decided to pick 6'5", and not 6'6", because I think 6'5" is a better thing. Here, I was just deciding, should I go max weight? Because I don't really lose anything if I go the littlest late, so I picked max weight just because nothing will happen. All right, this is where I gained my ball handling back with my wingspan. I picked the short. You always want to pick the shortest wingspan if you're trying to make a good shooting build, because you lose 3-point everything if you have a max wingspan. And I lose my ball handle, but if I go all the way down with the wingspan, I get an 87 ball handle, 88 three, and 84 mid range. So basically here, at the beginning of the year, no one knew to pick. Well, no, I personally didn't know what takeover to pick. And everyone was just who made a play shot would just pick shot creating if you want to do some. But now, if you want to be a Titan Cena wannabe or something like that, people still pick shot creating. But I think Sharp is better because it helps you shoot better and shoot for far range. And I've tested that. So now, since I've told you guys how to make the build, I'm going to show you guys the badge setup, basically, and how I put my 11 defensive badges, which I think, in my opinion, most play shots don't have because they're just basic. I'm putting testing at 99. All right, so you already know. Quick draw is an optional badge. Most people do gold or silver. I mean, gold or Hall of Fame. But Range Sender, Hall of Fame. Hot Zone Hunter, Hall of Fame. Green Machine, Hall of Fame. Deadeye, Hall of Fame. Then I'm just going to put the last badge on something random. And then that's it for the shooting. Playmaking Quick, First Step Hall of Fame, and Handles for Days Hall of Fame. Those are the only two badges you really need. And then Unpluckable Bronze and Bailout Bronze. And then I just put it on Dimer and Floor General because I'm thinking about my teammates. Because it boosts them and they're shooting. So I put Dimer and Floor General. And then I just put Unpluckable Silver because why not? There's nothing else to use that playmaking badge on. Here is when the good stuff comes in and why you should have made this build. Clamps, gold. You can get that on a normal play shot plus two other badges. But look at this. I can put Pickpocket, Intimidate Silver, Interceptor Silver, Pick Dodger Silver. I get all those defense badges on a regular play shot. A regular. I'm going to show you guys what it looks like, the badge setup looks like on a regular play shot. The badge setup I rocked on my play shot. So I had like 6 or 5. So I just put Intimidator. All right, that's the badge setup for defense. And then, of course, there's nothing else to put one finishing badge on but except contact finisher because you want to get some contact dunks or some dunks in general. Anyways, this is the badge setup for this play shot. Let me know if you guys like me doing build videos because I will. Anyways, peace. And nobody else has. I usually have an answer to the question.